Hello, Jack. I'm Dr. Gabriel Grant. You can call me Gabby.
It's very nice to meet your acquaintance, Gabby.
It's very nice to make your acquaintance as well. I'm always very glad to make new friends.
So where's your stethoscope?
I'm a different sort of doctor. I try and help kids with their bad feelings. Did your grandma tell you that you're going to be staying here with us for a little while? You don't look happy about that.
I like my toys at home better. You don't even have any Legos here.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Maybe your grandma can bring you some of your toys from home?
No, that's okay.
I like your pictures. Your grandma brought me some from home as well. Always with the bear. And the clown. Do they have any names?
That's Mr. Pinky and the bear's Captain Beasley. They're my friends.
What's wrong with Mr. Pinky's hands?
Nothing. Those are his fingers. Broken glass and razor blades and other sharp stuff like that. Scratching.
And just who does Mr. Pinky scratch with these?
Sometimes people make me mad.
Kid blames this clown for doing this to his mom.
And the neighbor's pit bull.
No, the bear killed the dog. It was Captain, help me out here.
Beasley. Captain Beasley.
Yeah. Jesus, this kid is split right down the middle.
So what are we thinking here? Is this dissociative identity or schizo?
Let's just wait and see what Gabby can get out of him first.
So, Mr. Pinky scratches the people you don't like? And what does Captain Beasley do?
He sort of protects me, like a shield.
Mr. Pinky is the sword.
Likes you.
He does?
But he doesn't like those men hiding behind the mirror.
They're not hiding, Jack. They're just...
They're hiding.
Kid doesn't miss a beat, does he?
Jack, we need to talk about what happened to your mom. What you did to her with the scissors. Jack? Jack?
I didn't do anything!
What the fuck was that?
I'd like to go back to my grandma's house now. You don't like me.
That's simply not true. I think you're a very smart, very special little boy. But I also think that you need help. Help to control your
imaginary friends. Take us home now.
I'm sorry, Jack. Your grandma is not ready for you to go home. Jack, please, I need you to control your feelings right now.
Jesus Christ, the glass is red hot.
Why is it so hot in here all of a sudden?
Do you believe in telekinesis?
Oh, come on, doctor. You don't think this kid is doing this with his mind?
How the hell do you explain what's going on? I mean, I'm about ready to call an exorcist.
Well, what do we do? Do we go in there?
Yeah, no, that's a good idea. Why don't you go?
Please don't. can't stop them now. And take me home. Can't stop them now.
Niñata de mierda.
¿Pero qué coño es esto?
Es el show de Timothy.
Dirás el show de los retrasados. Venga, dame el mando. ¿Qué pasa de ver esta mierda? ¡Que me des el mando!
No.
Niñata de mierda.
Llévame contigo.
Venga, anda, a la puta cama. A dormir. O llamaré a tus padres.
Thank you. ¿Qué será que llevo encima? Toda esa agonía insólita. Solita estoy, levita, grita, evita toda lógica. Cosmopolita, ya sabes cuál es mi forma de...
Sonia. ¿Pero qué coño te tengo dicho? ¡Que no te muevas de la habitación!
Es que, ¿Timothy está aquí?
¿Qué dices, flipado? ¿Lo habrás soñado o algo? Venga, anda, vete a dormir y deja de joder.
Sí, está aquí. Mira.
Well, Sally's birthday is actually on the 25th of December, but we don't think it's right that she gets more than her sister does on Christmas Day, do we?
No.
No, but it was her 10th and she always used to like soft toys, so we got her one of those custom-made teddy bears from the Make a Mammal workshop.
Paid for every extra, made it smell like bananas when you smell it. Everything.
Yes, and when you go in there, they let
you... Don't smell like bananas anymore though, does it? It smells like someone...
Well, no one's going to be able to smell it on the television, are they? So it's not a necessary detail.
Waste of fucking money.
Anyway, when you go in, they give you hearts to stuff right inside the bear's chest yourself, with your fingers. There's no blood, though, is there?
Not when they do it, no.
No, and they give the hearts to all the kids that come in, and they, what do they say to them? Rub it on your heart so it loves you. Rub it on your knee so it needs you. Rub it on your eyes so it cries when you're not there.
They put a lot of thought into the wordplay.
Yes, and you can buy these special hearts with a little button inside them. So when you give the bear a squeeze, the heart actually beats inside the bear's chest, like a real one, for what, 15 seconds or so? It's a cute idea.
In theory, yeah. But...
So on Christmas Day, we gave Dostoevsky to Sally.
We paid for it, so we got to name it.
We wanted to try and encourage her to read proper books when she grows up. We could have called it Dogstoyevsky if we got her a dog one.
I don't think they want other people to do the wordplay.
Which is fair enough, they're good at it.
She can't be trusted with dogs anyway.
No, not anymore. So, Sally gave the teddy bear a great big Christmas Day cuddle and she could feel its heart beating inside its chest. You should have seen her face light up. It was a picture, wasn't it?
Should have taken a picture. Back when she was okay in the head.
And then she says, Mummy.
Why is his heart stop beating?
Well, Sally, if you want his heart to keep beating, you have to give him a great big cuddle.
And the thing is, we didn't really think she'd feel quite so responsible for keeping the bear not dead.
She didn't sleep that night.
No, she just kept hugging him and hugging him and telling him everything was going to be fine. We didn't think anything was wrong at first. We just thought she really liked hugging it. In hindsight.
She didn't want to go to prison for murder.
No, so after 78 hours or so, she just conked out. God bless her soul.
I'm not sure she has a soul anymore.
No, by the time she woke up...
Not sure there's a God
well,
either.
She must have worn the battery out or the button got stuck because the heart just wasn't beating anymore. And, well, we didn't expect her to try quite so hard to bring Dostoevsky back to life.
Didn't expect a lot of things.
Every time she asked us to take her down to the butcher's on a Saturday morning, we told her the same thing.
Real organs won't bring it back to life.
But we didn't want to discourage her from being interested in science. It was making her read proper books, which is what we wanted in the first place. So we said she could use the basement.
We wouldn't let her have it upstairs, not with how soggy it got.
He got.
Sally, I told you not in the kitchen.
So, every day after school, she'd rush straight downstairs and with her doctor's books and put her little costume on and do her best to resuscitate the teddy bear.
We're not sure when she decided that conventional science wasn't enough, or to be honest, actually, how she even knew about the occult in the first place.
Yes, she did start drawing runes on the basement walls with a hopscotch chalk just after term started. Looking back, we really should have been a bit more suspicious when she offered to take Rufus out for walkies.
She never did like that dog.
Her sister was devastated when she saw the body. There was so much blood. It was all smeared round her mouth like blood. We don't know how much she drank of it in the end, but Rufus's carcass was dry as a desert by the time.
We did think about punishing her, didn't we? But we thought the better parenting choice would be to make her undo the damage.
She's down in the basement now because when the ritual succeeded, which did take us all by surprise, full credit to her, we made a deal with her. If she could bring Rufus back to life, like she did for Dostoevsky, then we'll get rid of Dostoevsky.
Here he is. You have to give him a bit of a squeeze above the sink just before you pick him up to minimise all the dripping, but other than that...
Sally doesn't play with him anymore. This is exactly why she doesn't get double at Christmas.
He does wait outside the basement door for her, pawing at it again and again, a bit like a kitten drowning in a sack. It'd be cute if it wasn't
actually happening.
Well, as Sally's back to not sleeping, for different reasons this time. He does love her, but, the feeling's not exactly mutual.
All that money we spent making it smell like fucking bananas.
He does love her. He does need her. He does cry when she's not there. Actually, it's more of a screech.
We haven't decided how we're going to put him down yet.
Not even sure if it's possible.
Rufus? Bill! Bill, it's Rufus. She's done it. Sally's done it. I told you she'd manage.
Excuse us.
No need to be grossed out. You'll find them in a lot of different crops. And remember, there are no danger to humans. Unlike this little bugger.
Sally was playing around with his friends and got a twig stuck in his ear. Mm-hmm. Believe it or not, I have seen this before. No. Don't be worried about anything. It's just boys being boys. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I love a Psycho. What? Do you think your mommy was gonna be down here? Hey! I'm talking to you, freak! Maybe I need to clear out your ears so you can hear me.
Watch out for Willy.
Your driving isn't bad. It's just a little, you know, sedate.
It's
safe.
Yeah.
Safe driving.
Yes.
It's belts and braces driving. Yeah.
Spirit of the war driving.
Yes, exactly. Yes. And making way for invertebrates.
I love turtles.
They're not invertebrates, you idiot.
What am I thinking of then?
Snails. They're gastropods. Very similar to turtles, only completely different.
Oh, good God, you're boring.
I know. Sorry. So, anyway, I've got Emily a little present. Just a small, cuddly toy thing. But do you think it's the sort of thing she might like? His whiskers are bent.
Look, it's really cute, and you've been so kind and thoughtful to think of buying her a present.
Is there a book coming?
I just don't want you to be disappointed. It's just that she's into penguins now. She's all happy feet and that was it.
But he's a very friendly lion.
Jeez, Nigel, I'm trying. Get that thing off me. Anyway, it's not big enough. She's sort of into bigger toys now and that's definitely not big enough.
Are we still talking about the lion?
Here we are. Home sweet home. Are you all right?
Yeah, why?
I don't know. You seem a bit nervous.
No, I'm fine. It's just that this is kind of a big deal, isn't it? I mean, there's a lot riding on this. I really like you. A lot. I'm really looking forward to meeting Emily. And it's important to me. To us. That she likes me. This really feels like the start of something special. And something that the three of us can build. Together.
Relax. Your big cheese ball.
Come quick.
Hello.
Get pizza. He's been hurt.
Oh, dear. Oh, no. We're going to need to take him to hospital.
We can't let him die, Mom. I need him.
We're not going to let him die. He's part of the family.
Well, Emily, it's a good job I'm here because I've brought a furry little friend with me. And I think you guys...
It's not big enough, Nigel!
He stopped breathing, Mom.
We need an ambulance.
I've already called them.
An ambulance? Rachel, is this a joke?
Where's the incident?
Sorry about this, fellas. It's a false alarm, I'm afraid.
Get the kit. We need to act fast. I need you to keep calm, sir. I need you to be brave for your loved ones.
I don't understand. What's going on?
I need you to breathe, okay? You're starting to panic.
I'm not panicking. I'm bloody confused. What's going on?
Do what you have to do to save him.
That's it. Just keep breathing.
We need to do a transfusion now.
We'll never make it to the hospital in time. We need somebody to give blood. Otherwise, it's not going to make it.
Oh, God, no! No, no, Peter!
Rachel, what is going on?
Sir, you're getting hysterical.
No, I'm not.
Listen to yourself, you're shouting!
This is ridiculous. Rachel, please! Rachel! Why are you crying?
This is a life or death situation.
Rachel. Will you stop crying, for fuck's sake?
Sir, mind your language, you're frightening the child.
I didn't mean to. Emily. Hakuna Matata. It's a wonderful phrase.
It's not big enough.
I think I should go.
What? We need you here. We need your help.
Yes, Nigel. We need you to be a man. We need you to step up.
I need to take a break. I need to go. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Some complications with Peter. The nice ambulance men did the best with what they had. I know how much you loved him.
I want my friend back.
I know, sweetheart. Which is why they've done something even better. You can come in now.
Peter! I thought I'd lost you. I love you, Mum.
I love you too, sweetheart. And look, he's even bigger than before.
Your friend sure is a fast runner.
Not anymore.
Una de la madrugada, 45 minutos, 1:45. Lucas, 12:35. Dios nos dice, estar siempre preparados y mantener las lámparas encendidas. Se siguen sumando más desaparecidos, informa la policía. Todos menores de 2 años. Su despertar se acerca y reencarnará entre nosotros.
Thank you.
was crucified.
Jesse, thank you so much.
Yeah, of course.
How was she?
Oh, she was great.
So we're still on for Saturday? 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock, okay, great.
Okay, thanks again.
Thank you.
What is going on with your face?
Nothing.
How many cookies did you eat?
I only had one.
One? That's a lot of crumbs for one cookie.
I only had one.
You know, I actually counted every cookie in that cookie jar. And if you did only have one, like I said, there should be exactly 13 cookies in that jar.
You didn't count them.
Our new cookie jar.
I do not like it.
Well, then don't put your hand in it. This cookie jar is for adults only. Anytime that a child has stolen a cookie from this jar...
Why would you bring that home?
Bree, no more cookies.
couple.
Are you gonna be okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, you know where my room is if you need me.
Bree, where's the cookie jar?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No.
Bree, did you take the cookie jar?
No.
Nobody likes a liar, Bree. Well, no more cookies in the house then?
No more cookies.
Where is she today?
She's painting.
Okay, well, we're still good for Thursday, right?
I'm not sure. No, she's gonna work.
Okay, well, I have your money here.
It's fine, send it to me. Thanks. Okay, I gotta go. Bye.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Mom.
Wow. Another masterpiece. Come on, it's way past your bedtime.
Wait.
I love you, monkey. Is everything good?
Yep.
Okay. Night, honey.
Good night.